So, having met last week, this is what I would have shown you from a big picture point of view, and that is a less than 2% increase that we were looking at, with some recommendations that I was going to suggest to you that got us there. So, since our vote on Monday with regard to the transfer station, and some adjustments I've made with some other information. It's a peer group, 3.3%. So we need to find some things. Here it is, 10,160 gets us to 2. But first, it still has some of these recommended actions, which you may or may not agree with. Which got us, these are what got us to 2, and then are still part of that 3.
So we still need to find another town to talk about that?
Yes. So one was to reduce the culvert from 20 to 10. I was playing around with reducing road maintenance, but ended up not doing it. And we talked about this a little bit on Monday, we reduced the third helper to 26 weeks at 15 hours a week.
Yep.
So I'll show you what that's like in the budget, because that's another thing. And then in the CIP, the boiler, the town hall boiler was recommended for 2018.
Yep.
My concern is, you know, we don't know what it is, we don't really know how much it costs. So my thought was to keep the 20K, put 10 in for 18,
right.
10 in for 19. Then next year we can look at what this replacement should be so that we can figure out. So with that, those are all in place. You don't have to keep them, but that
right.
They are in there. That is still, we still have this 3.1.
Okay. So I'm not opposed to that scenario with the boiler, but before we finalize, maybe we should talk to Bob. I know he's been sort of a point person on that, and see if it realistically we think it's going to last another year.
Okay.
It very well may. Sorry.
Go ahead, chatter. I can't forget the snow that Mike just said.
So is that with taking out paying for the furnace boiler at the transfer station that we moved out?
That's all in place in this.
Yes.
So that's kind of the big picture. So now it's up to you. Do you want to look at the CIP? At the detail of the CIP? Do you want to look at expenses? Do you want to look at revenue?
Yes.
I look at CIP first.
Okay, yeah. So we're here. Because the projections are in there. I just keep them there. So, let's take a look at it. So, here's the town hall boiler, and here's the action that I told you I was going to put in here for us to consider.
Okay.
Here's 100,000, which had been a recommendation from someone for the police station that would be there. And then there's 40,000 forevermore.
Mm-hmm.
And so, because it's here, if there's ever a bond, the payment on the bond is going to be offset by this 40,000 that the amount that's already in there plus the 40,000.
So, if all of it's adjusted, maybe that's fine.
So, there's that. I have this, I'm still unclear about this actually, and I'm only remembering now that I'm unclear. So, is this 25,000? For next year going forward?
No, it was supposed to be, I can discuss it with Bob again, but.
It's something about lease, and
it was supposed to be for 2 years to offset the cost of a lease to get the mileage more level. We have two vehicles that have very high mileage on them at the moment. So he wanted to play catch up, and then going forward, he would not lease any longer. He would go back to the person, so it should go back to 20. I can't remember if it was 2 or 3 years at this moment.
22.5, I think they said.
Okay.
So Michael, so this 25 covers the lease of two vehicles? Is that five in the reserve fund, not that we can't allocate it somewhere else. So that, you know, maybe that would help with the boiler issue too, if that. So.
Not, see if Bob will come in on Monday night to, have a conversation.
Yeah, cause that would be helpful. See, I can. Cause there's 22.5 in there already, because we thought this was, you know, cause we, it's last year's plus this year. Again, not to move around, but that's probably best. So Oldville Lane, you know, we've got stuff there. Yeah, right. Police Department expenses, 25, the message boarding for 2019 is here. Digital fingerprint for 20.
Right, 24 months.
Well, I said 2021 here, maybe I.
I think it was 2020.
Maybe I moved it around because of how the CIP looked in the off year, but. But anyway, we can sort of come back to that if you really want precision in those out of years. Air PAX filling station, 2019.
Yep.
And it already has, you know, 40,000 in there. Portable mobile radios, 2020. So it has a little bit, for next year, and then most of it in 2020. Paving the parking lot.
Let's move that out.
Until we can figure this thing out, and the same with this front ramp.
Yep.
Forestry vehicle is in there for 2020.
So there are no requests for you.
For the fire station, right. And the sewer upgrade is here.
Septic.
Is that what it is?
It should be septic.
Septic, thank you. Okay. Roadside mowing attachment is, you can barely see it, but it's, we're not putting anything in, we're taking this amount out, it's over in here.
Yeah.
Okay. Replacing the top kick is going to happen in 2019, based on what George said, so there's 30,000 going in this year to get it to the 190. Utility with the plow truck, coming out hopefully in 2018, at least that's the expectation, so there's 20 there. And so this 22 would give us the 42. The skid steer, there's, I think 11 already must be, there's 11 already there, so the additional 22 would come in outer years. The replacement for the International is scheduled for 2025. Replacing the Ford, scheduled for 2026. The boiler, we heard from George, I don't know, we have it in 2027.
Yeah.
So, backhoe replacement, we're scheduling that whenever, 2027, so we're gonna start to put stuff in next year. Replacing the roof, 2024. So that's the highway department. Is that?
Yep.
Jive with what you know? Okay. Replacing the older, municipal solid waste compactor, I have 2033, so there's some money way at the end of this.
Yeah.
And we don't, and this is just there so we don't forget.
Yeah, we want to put it on the schedule so we can see that.
So if you add all those things up, that gives us, that suggests a warrant article that says, please place $188,200 into the CIP reserve fund. Do you want to do this? Okay? So that's the money going in. The money going out, you have to total it up. I think I have to add some on this thing. So that's what the CIP is.
So really, realistically, for the CIP, the only three places to pull from are police, highway, and general ed. If we're gonna remove 10,000 somewhere here, or
oh,
a
I see.
Combination.
You're gonna move something here.
Those are the only three places.
Yes, you'd be looking at what makes up this $188,200, and it is stuff from the highway station and things of the GMC, so if we take it out of here, we add it here, and it starts to make the outer years higher. The police, the leasing.
Yeah. So we're suggesting for 100 and, trying to think back to the conversation, 100 and for 2018.
It came from Bill Irving, I think. And I think it was because he thought there was more in here, there's 25.
Both thought there was more, I mean,
And it probably was, we did move things, you know, just to get moved around.
So if we were, I would feel more comfortable doing it there, if that's where, if we were gonna do anything from the CIP.
With this line right here.
From that line there.
Okay, so make it 90, make it 80?
What, yeah.
Okay.
But.
Yeah, all right. So that's the CIP.
We'd go to the operating budget too, but.
Yeah, is that where we wanna go now, next?
Jody wants to go, she said, yeah, we're gonna make you.
Yeah.
Her choice next.
Whatever you feel like doing.
So.
I'm fine. So here's executive. If there's nothing yellow, means there's really nothing that's changed since the last time.
Okay.
So I'll stop if you want, we'll go.
There wasn't anything that jumped up the last time I had this conversation in the session, but I think
so this is zeroed out. This, right, this
oh, yeah, you put it all in there.
It's all here. So the last the year that we're currently in, the combination of those two lines is this, for a budgeting perspective.
Yeah.
The combination, now, once consolidated, is going to be 1,600, so it's an increase of 100.
Okay. Will that come with it?
It's the lease plus the maintenance contract.
What happens if anything else goes wrong?
Such as?
Well, the office equipment just isn't the copier.
Go ahead. Such
so
as?
We have her copier, you know, her tower.
Computer equipment.
Right.
That's
so
out of the,
that
so that's the IT.
Yes.
So soft,
what else are you considering office equipment?
That's what I'm asking
machine,
you.
Fax machine.
The fax machine and the copier, I'm told, now does fax.
Yes.
Oh, so then that's covered, right? And it's a scanner too, right?
Mm-hmm.
A new one, so.
So I'm just making
that equipment
is
that should be obsolete.
I'm not sure what else we're covering other than computer equipment, which comes out of this line.
Okay.
Right here.
And if that's contingency, which is ever
helpful.
I know ever helpful if you didn't see, but just in case, like if we had to, I guess we could move something out of IT. I'd rather think so.
And this is the increase from the geo map.
Oh, yeah.
Reversible expenses is up, but it's covered by, it's entirely covered by revenue, so it has no impact on the tax effort.
You lower professional fees?
Yep. Would you like to see them? There was the three of us going through all of this stuff.
No.
I feel quite sure.
Oh, no, I don't know. I need to talk right then.
You set it up for us. You had the table here. You were here early. I believe you.
It means it wasn't in the recovery, though.
That is true. So here's what we have scheduled. We haven't done this yet,
yeah.
Although we're closer. We're closer than we were last year.
Yeah.
The MOA on Oak Street, so that to encompass more than just what it currently does,
yeah.
To include the actual maintenance of the roads. Compliance, we have our favorite objects of, our favorite goals here. That we've not been able to do because other things come up.
Yep.
The cell tower lease, which if successful can have an offsetting revenue amount, but we don't know what.
Okay.
You know, there isn't anything built.
Yeah.
You know, I haven't offset this by anything.
Yep.
This is just a potential as we're deciding what we want to do next year with our dollars.
Mm-hmm.
Just in case there's any FERC hydro licensing effort that is required by us, you know, we'll look past it. General legal, something usually comes up. And then there's 11,000, which even though this is Sligo Road, it's just 11,000 for whatever we think the priority should be, whether it's looking at the village and planning storm drain upgrades,
yep.
Whatever it is. So that's what's in professional services.
Okay.
It's last year we weren't sure where we're going to the bond council was in here, and now her fee was distributed to the actual loans. We had the potential for getting help to find whatever, which we decided we didn't need to do. So that's why overall this is less than it was last year. Those are a couple of the items that are no longer there. Anything else in executive that we want to look at? Okay, so elections. Since the last time, Kate sent, I'd say all of us, I'm not sure if it would have been just me, she says, could you please put another voting booth in the budget? So there's the other voting booth in the budget.
Okay. That's
the
four-way,
the
three-way.
It's exactly like the one we got. Which does allow, I think, a wheelchair to come up, if I'm right?
Yes.
Two standing and one wheelchair.
Okay.
And it's a circle.
Yeah, one of them's low enough so it's right there. I don't remember. I don't know.
All right, so I'm just going to get rid of that once we put that in. So we're still waiting for some of the stuff from Avatar. I did hear on the appraisal, and there's a 25% increase. So I think I sent her an email and said, hello, this is a 25% increase. Can you tell us what it is? And she says, you've been using more services, but she was going to go into the office and check. So I'm going to keep these highlighted because I said, well, okay, well, there's mapping and there's the license for the information systems, license and maintenance. So, you know, there could be still some changes here. Personnel administration. All right, so let me review this line. So there's there's only a 6.10% increase in this line, even though we've got one new person now that we're covering,
mm-hmm.
a whole person. So we know that, you know, the level of that person is now taking. So this has been built to cover people's plans as they exist today.
Right.
And there's, of course, the overall 6.1% decrease in premiums.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So this line, we've got some people who are single. So what if they become two people or family?
Right.
So this is just there as an insurance, no pun intended, or maybe pun intended, to cover changes in this
mm-hmm.
line. So it's like a mini contingency for this in particular.
Mm-hmm.
And if it's not used, then we can consider buying out some of the sick leave stuff that we are considering right now. So that's what this line is.
Which might happen.
I'm sorry.
Which retirement?
We might be forced.
Yeah.
So it's termination payments.
Yeah.
Insurance. Yeah. So we could be forced to. That's a good point. this line, I don't know how we, how nobody noticed this last year, but payroll taxes were just wrong.
Right.
So
correct.
That's why this looks so weird. But, government buildings. So yeah, we've been paying for the testing out of the actual water utility unit.
Right.
So I just, it'll come out of the maintenance. Transfer station is up because of the compactor sheds. I think we've looked at all of this. Cemeteries, that includes $1,000 for computer stuff,
computer equipment,
possibly software licenses.
Yeah.
Insurance, this is the quoted price, regional associations, these are, we've already received their next year's dues. There's the police, so there's the chief salary, there's this salary line, which includes. So in here, in this budget amount, is not the increase that we provided to the lieutenant. So this line includes that, the FY17 salary base with that salary adjustment.
Gotcha.
Okay, to which then we then apply the 3% per merit increase. So here's, this is the full-time salary base, 3% merit is this,
mm-hmm.
So that adds to this, and we consolidated the holiday pay in this line as well, so that's an extra 10,000. Not an extra 10, it's, the line had 10,000, that's now in there. Yeah. And these are the part-time salaries, no increase. Yeah, let's, I think, I don't, we don't need to, oh yeah, so here's the holiday that could just get reduced to zero. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. So I'm going to do this.
Will the overtime go up now that we lost a part time?
Well, did we ask Bob that question?
I don't know.
I think
we
did,
actually.
And I think he said no, and he had a reason.
Because there were enough part-time officers that
to cover it.
And what?
Yeah.
And our new guy is going to be coming on board at some
yeah.
point.
Okay.
So
he's halfway through.
So I think, because I agree with Mike. I think we did ask him, and he said no. So is this? Did you find out anything about dry cleaning?
I'm not even going back.
So that's still, the uniforms line is still this then.
Potentially that could be 4,700.
It's 4,750 right now. This is no increase from last year.
Right.
So if there's any dry cleaning service, it would be.
We didn't have a budget last year?
No.
Yeah. No. It's a new. No, it wasn't. You've got it in the current year's budget and for the next year.
Here?
Isn't that 2016 right there?
That's 2017.
Yeah.
I think that's just his uniform budget. I don't think it included right in. Yes, this is just, do we want to include dry cleaning and what does it cost? That's okay, Mike. It's taking on a switch. So this is highlighted because if you recall, whatever we had, Chief Rutherford came in and said, can I have 40?
Right.
Really should be 45, you know, I prefer to be 40. So I did add this 1,000 to talk to us about.
Okay.
So whatever you saw in the 10-year projections does include this. So you know, that's a place
right.
where we could drop it back down. It's a pittance, really, but I did add that. I'll keep it highlighted because just so that we don't forget that this is just my idea and it may not be fully, fully whatever, approved. highways and streets. So now
what
here we
are building and payroll type of highlight.
revenue.
Oh, okay.
The green's saying there's revenue.
Gotcha, that's green, not yellow. I gotcha, okay.
It just, it reminds me to make sure we're, you know, taking care of that or, so that, and actually, you know, building permits bring in more than his salary, so. All right, so this now should represent, you know, the seven, let's take a look at it, actually. Oh, right. So it is $17 hourly rate. This many hours of overtime, I have no idea what's going to work, right? So but this is based on this plus
right.
this at time and a half.
Right.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
These are the payroll taxes, it's just Medicare that we have to cover, so it's small. That's why it's so small. Retirement system, the health. This was just an estimate. It's really not like that.
Is that the high end for a family?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Yes, yeah. But so if we're talking to people and they ask, it's roughly, you know, a $60,000 to $64,000 overall increase in our operating budget with this person. Without offsetting some of the decreases, like to part time help, right? So that's not there. We get I've got a place for it, so we can put that in once we're a little more solidified.
Mm-hmm.
So this will offset this increase.
So we've made an offer, right?
Where he's hired.
He's hired.
He's
on board.
He's on board.
So, has he signed up for benefits yet?
Yes. Yeah.
So
I didn't want to change this. Yeah, because we don't want to, again, for privacy's sake.
Right. Okay.
So his health insurance is somewhere else. I'll just keep this as a placeholder.
Okay.
It's a good way to talk about it without being specific.
Suffice to say, it's not. Really.
It isn't. So here, so that's where this comes from.
Right.
This is, so let's look at part-time staff. I think that's about here.
I guess I have one question. So
sure.
We're not budgeting for full time.
Correct.
Okay.
Correct. We're budgeting for exactly
okay.
That insurance line is budgeted with what we know
really?
Everybody's
okay.
Taking
that's
right this
okay.
Year.
Okay.
And then
we've
got
that was
five.
The case, but I had to ask.
Yeah, no, good question. So, all right. So here's the highway department part-time labor. At this is 26 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
And if we want to do, this is 52 weeks. If we want to do half, it would be 54.60. And then this is the snowplow. So, and I, you know, if you've got some other ideas about this, it would be helpful. So, here are the number of hours that we've been using. Now, up until right now, we've only had one employee with a CDL, and only one employee who's really plowing. So, the 16-17 season, we used 700 hours.
Mm-hmm.
The 15-16, we used 326 hours. And 14-15, 509 hours.
Mm-hmm.
So
okay, part-time.
A part-time snow plowing help.
Okay.
So at a $20 an hour rate, I budgeted 500 hours, and that's where we got this. Now the question is this, do we think, because we now have two full-time highway department persons, that we can reduce our part-time help to 15 hours a week, 26 weeks a year?
Can we fit 26 and 52 and a half?
We could do
any flyers, and we're still gonna need.
We could do it.
I don't want to cut too tight because now they're gonna be doing a lot of in-house work.
And we had this conversation right the other night, right, with George, and
I've, so what you were saying with the 3-point-something% increase overall, I've already reduced that line because here it is under this adjustment. So if we put this...
Oh, you want to say that again? So you've already done that in the budget?
Yes. So if
so
we
in
put...
the budget, you already made it 26 weeks.
I did.
Okay.
Yes. So but I put it here because I didn't want to...
Right.
Okay.
Right. So I feel really strongly that... I feel really strong that we need to reduce it to 26. That's my strong position on this.
So that gives us what, spring, summer, month, right?
Yeah. Scenarios and play it out. It's not just words. Because I'm not going to be swayed by words.
Right.
And if I'm not going to be swayed by words, you're going to have a hard time with the town.
Right.
So we need
to... we can try it for a year. I mean, you could try it at halftime for a year and see how it works. I mean, count the... 26 weeks from now, half a year ago, I never said. We could try it and see how it works.
I mean, if we've got one person who's willing to come in, like sort of ad hoc, so that's
right.
The best of all possible worlds. I don't know about our other person, but that we're not necessarily, you know, we're going to try to figure out what he...
So the model we have now is one more permanent part-time person, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's Wayne.
Me, right, this very minute?
Right.
Yes, till the end of the year.
Like an ad hoc.
An ad hoc other person.
Comes and goes.
Yeah.
More consistency and regularity, I guess, now.
Perhaps.
Perhaps.
I think
I don't even
there's,
know
yeah.
But
yeah.
He's not there every week, so.
He's there maybe as needed. More as needed.
Yeah, there'll be 2 weeks when there's nothing. And then he'll be there for a day or so.
Yeah. So will the, we don't know if we do move to this model.
Two full-time and...
Well, we already know that we're doing that, but...
Yeah, two full-time and in 26 weeks.
Part-time person. There's no guarantee that the person that's got the position now wants to take the winter off and come back in the springtime. Right?
Correct.
So,
correct.
Anyway.
Correct.
And we're left with the one person that may come in one day a week or may not come in for 3 weeks.
Correct.
So,
you know, maybe some of the transfer station attendants would want to on a spot basis. I mean, you know, it's hard to say. But from a budgetary point of view,
that covers most of the summer. That covers most of the summer. I just did it by
month or week.
But we still have our winter seasonal help, right? So if we had to, if we found we needed to get someone in, and it's a magical person that we didn't actually hire, who come in and assist with like cleaning trucks and things, we do have some money to take out of there, right? If we have
I'm sorry, I was doing that. So what my
so, like, so with the winter help, the highway to run the snow plow.
Right here,
it,
yeah.
If we found like one of the guys on the highway department, I was part of the transfer station,
mm-hmm.
we need to ask or to come and help clean the trucks or something.
Mm-hmm.
If we needed that, George needed that one. We have some I don't want to call it cushion, but some flexibility within the seasonal that line to cover those costs.
Well, we think so. I mean, we're hoping we don't have to use them.
Right. Well, I mean, I've been hearing though that especially with 700 hours that. We may have been going a little overboard with some of our plowing techniques.
It's possible.
Mm-hmm.
We're sending, they're both going to the green snow throw class,
so
weather
potential
permitting.
For,
yeah.
The techniques that George had mentioned that they employ over in South Burl are a little different than what we were doing. I don't know if they're better or if they're worse. I guess we're going to find out when winter finally comes. So I think, I think that 500 is a much more realistic number, and then it may be even less than that. So, depending on how bad the storms are,
yeah.
Exactly.
So.
So I think all right. So we and I have got our feathers up or a pair up or whatever on the 26th.
I think we could try it.
I guess. I mean, at first blush, I was like, no way, I don't think it's gonna happen anymore.
Maybe
mm-hmm.
rid of the slime.
Didn't work and we tried again any different than the year before, right? So let's try it. And I think you're absolutely right, Suzanne. We're asking we got a full time.
I know this is
the easy
yourself.
That's what I mean. I think you're absolutely right with the selling to the tenant. And how do you say, we want a full time assistant? Oh, by the way, we're not getting rid of anybody else.
Mm.
I mean
it's a little like hard.
We can try, yeah.
We reviewed this now with real data, so So I just combine safety equipment and safety shoes into the.
Is that
into
one. Now that we have a full time assistant.
Well, this was what George and Jody had suggested.
Okay.
But,
George
George still has a pair from his previous town that he hasn't worn, so he's going to be using them sometime this year. They're still brand new, still in the box.
Thank you, Seth Berwick.
Yeah, exactly.
Berwick, whatever, well, part of the Berwick. Thank you, by the way, what's your name?
Just a reminder, this is down because we're now on our, wherever Bay Ring is, all these
days. Yeah,
oh,
for the, yeah.
Thank you for stopping there. Now that we have two, they're going to be on call. How do we deal with the phone? Are we going to give our second road agent phone, road labor phone, when they're on call?
George had said no. He said they would handle it.
They just use the same one, I guess.
He said that they did not need a second phone when we were sitting, the three of us.
Because right now he has his phone. The police helped him get the phone. The highway department phone rings on his personal phone now. So,
I
only has to carry one phone.
Yeah, I was going to say, I wouldn't want to carry two.
So, if Ed's on call, then Ed must be taking the town phone. It's probably how it's going
to
work.
Could be. I mean, that's kind of, you know,
okay.
I'm sure they'll.
I just
so
wanted to make sure we didn't have to put in a second phone.
So, if I hate to actually bring this up, but I just, in all fairness, so if George is using his personal phone to have calls forward, which is his choice, would we entertain any kind of offset, like monthly offset, even if it's like $25 a month?
No.
Or his cell phone bill?
I would not. He doesn't have to use his phone.
No, it still would be cheaper than getting another line, wouldn't it, and making him carry another phone.
Well, not getting another line.
No, well, I think they both should have one. I don't think that
George said they
George
don't
should
need
have one all the time. The other phone should just stay in the highway shed.
I think it's micromanaging. I mean, you know, if our road agent has come and said, this is sufficient, what we have is sufficient.
Well, so we do micromanage all the time. That's why I'm just. sometimes it's inconvenient.
Stop it.
So I'm just like, we're all guilty of that. So, all right. It's not that I don't trust George. That wasn't the point. It's just, I'm just very concerned that we would be able to reach these folks.
It's a new,
we'll
it's a new
work.
Configuration.
We'll let a house go.
Okay. Supplies is up because of wanting to do some more in-house stuff, and equipment is up. Just I think equipment is up for these reasons. There's still a potential for a trailer, an explosion-proof flammable storage cabinet, and small fridge. So it doesn't include the lock thing, which we're going to try to do this year. Though I haven't had time, I know I haven't had time to look at it yet. This is increased because our vehicles are getting older, and based on what happened this year, this seems to be prudent. Vehicle fuel is the same. Signs, this includes the upgrade to the stop sign. We're going to see that it happens.
What's that, the signs?
Yes, it's going to happen this year.
We'll see.
No line striking per George's recommendation needed this year. And that's what funding is some of the other things. Tree maintenance, we've got $5,000 in the budget.
How, we'll do more work in houses. Oh, that's shoulder work, though.
Yeah, so that's why there's an increase in sand.
Didn't we have a list of, like, I'm not looking to spend money, but didn't we have a list of, like, 40 trees? I'm sure the storms that we've had in the last couple of weeks probably took care of some of them, but I can't imagine all of them taking care of it, and we didn't do any this year, right?
Well, there's still a purchase order, so
we still haven't
done
it, though, have we? I mean, it's running out of year. I mean,
it's running out. Last year
we
had
a lot to do, so
last year we did it in December.
Okay. It's not a knock on George. It's just time is running out. That's all. And he's got a lot to deal with before the snow starts flying. So,
are you wanting to recommend to us that we increase?
No. I just want to make sure that we're really confident. Let me get out my crystal ball. I know, I'm sorry.
Why should that line be any different?
I know.
It's our best guess.
You can just say, just look at me and say, cool, that's fine. One more is fine. You can take the highlighting off of the line striker.
Oh, yeah, okay.
There was one dead on Bear. That might have been the one that walked it. There was one on Sligo. That might have been one.
That'd be great if it was.
We did lose some trees, so, and once they're down, George can go with a chainsaw and get rid of them, so.
Yeah, anything fallen was run, there's three there. Or Foundry.
So we will ask him if we think of it when he's in, right, about the.
Because he was getting a quote from another company.
Street sweeping is down just based on usage.
Okay.
Cold patch hot mix is up because of more in-house work.
Yeah.
Salt is holding steady because the price per ton has fallen.
Right.
So we used our budget, we've leapfrogged our budget this year.
Yeah.
But our rebudgeting, we're hoping, holds us through to the end of the year because these costs come in once we sign that contract. So we're actually on these reduced costs right now.
Okay.
It's reduced the tonnage cost. So, you know, could create a shortfall next year if it goes up a lot. But so roadside mowing has been reduced to zero because we're expecting to purchase that attachment. Otherwise, we'll have to put $3,000 into this budget. Stormwater management, I'm loath to reduce this only because our permit is supposed to come effective next year, and it's we may need to spend some dollars in order to make some things happen.
Yeah.
Catch basin cleaning, that's sort of standard.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so no separate warrant article. I was going crazy with little pieces here, little pieces there, offset here, offset there. This is our road. Suzanne does. One voice crying in the woods. There is $108,000 offset. So 50 of it is the one-time supplement. The rest is out of regular.
It is the highway grant.
Yes. Yeah. I think this is clear. I think it's easy to understand. This is my recommendation.
So we didn't use any of the supplement from this year?
We did not.
Offset the engineer?
No.
Yay!
Yeah, big yay.
Oh,
the
yay.
50 is the, well, that was the supplement.
Now, we still may, but I don't think so, because there's, I'll tell you Monday.
Everything's still
on
it.
Well, let me tell you now, it's no big discovery. So everything is in with the exception of legal for a certification Steve has to do.
Okay.
And in order for him to do it, he needs the loan amount. So he's got to do it, you know, so we can't add that legal fee onto the loan. That's going to be like three digits, so that's not a big deal.
Okay.
The final pay rec is in and it's taking its course. Oil Tanner has we've got all the construction oversight in place, and we're about $30,000 under budget. But what's missing is the engineering cleanup, document prep, getting some of the records in place. Like, they found out a lot of things when they did the drain pipe in the old mill, at the lower mill, I mean. And so he said probably between $3,000 and $5,000 for that. And they have to file that Army Corps of Engineers report for us. So if we can, I think we can find that in our budget. I'm asking Caroline to do our professional services for about 20 minutes a week. I think we'll be able to find that within the budget that won't require us to go into the So, but that is a pot that we could conceivably use.
So the question is, putting it into the budget makes it cleaner. I understand that. So, I'm just trying to think what the arguments are for and against having a separate one article. Pro, you can either reduce or increase as needed, right? And I guess the same thing.
Either place, right.
So that's what I'm trying. I'm just thinking it through. So.
Although here, depending on what it is, I mean, we don't have to.
Whatever select board, but us or the next select board can say, all right, fine, you've reduced our budget by $100,000. We have license over the budget. We can take it out somewhere else. We don't have to take it out. They don't have to take it out.
Right.
On
the other hand, if they reduce the warrant article, we could still say, okay, we'll just supplement it from the operating budget somewhere.
Yeah.
you know, if we feel there's this much road work to do, you know, the board will, I assume, will try to figure out a way to do it.
We've talked about it before, so.
Look at Barrington, Barrington's on the line.
I can't say it, I don't know. Do most communities just bake it into their operating budget, or is it a separate warrant article? Or if it was at one time, if they decided to go to this.
Well, if you're a city, it's different, right?
Of course.
And so it's all in one, it's in one line. I know Barrington's on the one line.
Does Barrington have a board of selectmen, or do they have a town council?
They have a select board.
Right.
They have a town manager or administrator.
Yeah. So.
And have a highway department.
What was that?
They have lots of highway department, they have a lot.
They have a lot of miles, it's a big town.
Big town.
Yeah, their road budget is much bigger.
Right, as the public works director, she goes to, I think it's public works director, she goes to one of the,
Oh,
TAC.
Yeah. Yeah, they have a big department.
So if you can touch down on this.
All right. I'd like to look at, what's on me, I get it. Yeah, I'd like to look at, see what other small municipalities like us do without a town manager. All of us do on fuel of them every year.
I don't know what having a town manager, how that's relevant, I just mentioned it.
Because they handle all of this. They do handle the budgeting and the day-to-day. You do it for us as our board chair, and we're very appreciative of that, and saying we have Caroline.
I still don't know, I guess, how that makes a difference.
This is cleaner, right? I get that. It's
just easier to understand.
Yeah,
it's just not just for, just easier. Here it is. This is what we spend. This is about what we should be spending every year. It's not necessarily an extraordinary, doesn't represent an extraordinary activity.
Right. I'm good to go.
Although this year it's higher by about 50,000 that we'll maybe spend because of the 50,000
supplements.
Yeah. Street lighting, you know, we do have some repair requests in line. Caroline has no idea when they could, when Eversource would need them. So if something comes in, we need to look for that funding somewhere else in our budget.
I wonder how many, we have quite a few outstanding requests, don't we?
I don't know what the number is. I know what the amount would be. I don't know how many this represents, I guess. So, could ask Caroline.
Yeah, no, I don't bother with that, but I just popped out of my head and I said, oh, look.
So this line is increased now because I add 120 hours per year to cover brush chipping. So that's why this has been increased. And I checked with George, and he said, it's, yes, 10 hours, 10 hours a month should cover that.
Okay.
Uniforms cleaning, somehow I have in my head that maybe this is a bigger amount.
Yeah, we can reduce that. We've spent only $559.
Did we start it at the beginning of the year?
We started it, had to go through town meeting, so we started it, I believe, in March.
You think it's two full quarters?
Yes.
Two full quarters are in there, how much?
500. So.
So it's just a.
So we'll have one new person full time, and everybody else is the same. So
this is just the transfer station.
No, you put in the one. Where's the uniform cleaning?
Oh, I see. Only I fall into this trap every time. So this is, even though it's under here,
it's highway.
It's both highway.
Yeah. All the guys get stuck in the same place.
So.
Okay. You say a word which I don't have an opinion on.
Okay. We've only spent
Yeah, well, we've got a new person. We've got a new person.
Right.
We know there's somebody at the transfer station who's not choosing it. So if we hire, if that person leaves.
Yeah. So there's some that use it in the wintertime more than the summertime. We have some that didn't realize that certain pieces of equipment were available for them.
Okay.
So probably 2,000 should be okay.
And I didn't put it in. Could be. I'm gonna do my best, but it could be. All right. So. No, I get rid of it. I didn't mean to. But I get rid of it. It's just this I want to do. Thank you. All right. Well, this is the telephone that could. Yeah, it was the transfer station. Yeah, sorry, I was wrong about the other one, but anyway. So I did reduce, if you recall, we had, I had budgeted this with a, I don't know, 5% increase in tonnage or something. And based on what we said, I think it's just a 1%. increase in the garbage,
oh, yeah.
The tonnage.
Yeah.
Okay, so this is based on the dollar per increase for the tonnage plus a 1% increase in the overall tonnage from 650 to 657.
Okay,
so that's where that's from. Now, we don't know about hauling unless you have something you can add.
Nothing now. They just met last night, so.
And George was going.
George went. I haven't heard from him yet.
So this could be a source of interest, right? Now we know we're reducing our haul, thank God. We're reducing our need for hauling.
Yes.
But it could still.
Right, they move to Epic.
Exactly.
It's going to cost more for mileage.
But if we move to Epic, we can just go to Shipyard and we'll reduce our mileage.
But there may be a cost to doing that.
Right.
So we're just not sure.
Right.
So it still could be.
Yes.
So if it's on, yeah, we've got it on yellow. We'll keep it yellow. I'm going to take this one though. I think we're all set, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
But they're doing great. They're packing them in.
It's
10 to 14 tons each. They're going out now.
So this has been reduced to zero.
Yep.
I've added salary dollars to the transfer station, so I think we'll get rid of the yellow. This is based on Chief Ducharme's recommendations. This is the same. And the control, Chief Ducharme. General assistance, we've got this.
Before we move on, I know.
So the only thing that could be helpful in thinking, I mean, I'm worried about this too, to be honest with you. But, you know, this is a little bit of a safety net here. I mean, while we have to, there's no obligation.
Yep.
So we could use some of this community assistance to but it, you know, it's like, it feels a little like special ed, only not quite so dire because we're not going to get hit with 100, you know,
one child.
Right.
Yeah, we haven't had food or utilities use at all.
probably not food, because we generally sell them to the food pantry.
I thought we had one this summer, but maybe we authorize it and it never
sometimes
happens,
that's true. Sometimes we authorize things and it doesn't happen. So this is what Jody was just looking at, so and again, this is a little bit of a safety valve here. And I haven't looked at the folder. My guess is this request maybe is more than 7,000, but I, you know, when I look at it, I'll just let you know I'm not necessarily inclined.
Yeah, they're in my folder, all stacked together,
yeah.
And a paper cut.
Yeah. So these should represent the new numbers, Jody, for summer day camp.
For the summer that I just gave you this morning.
I don't think this one changed.
That one didn't change.
Yeah, so this one represents what you just gave me
this morning.
Yep, and they both had, they're both completely offset by revenue. I'm nervous, but we don't have to talk about now. That's a meeting kind of a discussion. So I'm just going to.
And if the teen camp doesn't come to fruition,
we don't spend it. So.
Right.
No, we do have still have to spend
it. We still have to raise it, though.
We still have to raise it.
That's the problem.
We have to raise it. And we have to raise the full appropriation.
That's why I'm a little concerned as well.
However,
I'm not opposed to doing it.
So let's think it through. So we have to raise it.
Yep.
It will have no offsetting revenue because it didn't happen.
Yep.
So then the amount of money that we've raised and didn't spend will add to fund balance. So. It's not that it's completely, but exactly,
right.
But that's what happened. So we've done that, I'm trying to think of another situation where, well, it's a little bit like the FEMA stuff. I mean, if we don't have so if we have to raise it,
mm-hmm.
If we don't spend it, we don't have the offsetting revenue, but it'll stay in fund balance, so.
The difference is we have X amount of years of history that shows us that we always get, in several years, we've gotten more in the FEMA than we've actually.
Well, we got some grants this year. Yeah. So.
Yeah, like snow emergencies and stuff like that. We tend to always get that, but we don't have any history here because we're brand new, so that's why it's kind of scary.
Well, this past year, it was done in all these grants for the radios and the Homeland Security.
Yeah.
It's FEMA/Homeland Security, whatever.
Yeah, not sure.
Do you want me to go back to rec and bring it back down to like a 3-day camp?
Jody, I don't, you know, they're coming Monday, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So we could talk to them, but that just so that we know what it means.
Right. And I think they need to understand too, because, you know, I don't want to just assume they don't, but in case they don't, I mean, they may not realize that we have to raise the money. They could say in a couple months, you know, April, okay, yeah, we don't really want to do it now. We're committed now to, you know, raising the $35,000.
So it's something to talk about. I mean, if there's some degree of uncertainty, maybe they want to work on the planning for another year, or maybe try 2 days.
Yeah.
But whatever's here, we're raising.
Okay.
Yeah.
We are raising.
Okay, they went to rec. It's 87. That's okay. What?
Yeah,
put my glasses on.
Fancy. It's gold-plated basketballs.
That's okay, that's gone. No one volunteered to step up to do that. No rain.
All right.
No.
Well.
The ice people left, no one knows anything about ice.
All right. So, you know, I don't have the libraries in hand, but just by the way. But I think from an email I got from Sarah, she said 3%.
I mean, traditionally, although I don't know if they do, I don't have a memory of them doing last year, traditionally they come in.
presented to the select.
Well, they don't need to, but just by courtesy,
just so
we usually
know.
Get their, we got
right.
their thing last year. They didn't
right.
come, but they sent it to us.
Right.
So I'll ask again, but that's why it's so highlighted.
And not for us to nitpick, but to at least realistically plug it in.
Exactly.
So
right, exactly.
Yeah, I don't want them to think that that's the reason. But.
Okay, so no changes here. Capital projects. So I don't actually have them as separate items, but this is the cruiser, which is the 25 plus the 22, the mowing attachment and the utility truck. So that's this capital project. This also is not a taxation issue because if we spend it, it comes from the Conservation Land Trust Fund.
Capital project, but so that doesn't include the money for going into the town hall. No, no, the
that's up in
the police station, basically. You had 100,000.
This is out. This is spending out. These are projects that we're spending for.
Okay.
It's here.
Yeah, okay.
That's okay. So this is the outlay expected next year.
Yeah.
The cruiser, or this could be a lease arrangement, is what I'm hearing. But I've got 47,500. The mowing attachment and the utility truck. So those will be here as individual lines when we get greater clarity with agreement or whatever. Financing, this one's still an estimate. This is no longer an estimate, right? But this is still an estimate that based on, you know, we need to close on this feature. So,
81.2,
yep. I think it will only decrease because we've come in over a longer budget. So reserve funds, this is, I should take a look at this. I think it's 188 now, so.
Well, looking at all of this, we're at the end of the budget now, right?
Yes.
To me, the most logical place to cut.
Well, we're not in revenue, we haven't moved to revenue, but
okay. Okay.
Hold that thought. So now, Mike,
I need to go back up to the CIP for this year.
I'm going to close the two because that's just going to be useless. It's just a bit of a case. It's a mistake in the news. So let's take a look at our. Here's the midpoint increase. So we need to find $9,360.
I'd like to cut $10,000 from the this fund for this year, the town of the building. We've got $100,000.
Yeah.
Actually, I'd like to cut $20,000.
this 80?
I would be behind the others, but I yeah, I would.
Have they started?
Yeah.
Jody, did you?
Even 8 months might make sense, but I'll, let's just look at it. If you don't mind, just let me know.
So, okay, so yay.
I guess you were.
We've got this, yes,
where you
much better.
A little,
yeah.
I mean, a little less because you had 1.97.
Yeah, I'm not happy with 2019, but this
yeah.
is the one we're really focusing on.
Mm-hmm.
We can
move things around.
We can
we
move
to.
Things around if we have to next year.
So if we could, if we decrease it by 20%, it's going to make 2019.
It does,
so
yes, but that,
and that's
right.
No boiler this
year.
Right. Right, but 10,000 for it. So 10,000.
Putting money in for it, so.
Putting money into it.
Right.
Which we, you know,
if
we don't
but
spend
we don't know
more,
from the chief, right, if he really
and
thinks.
And then when we don't have the team camp and it blows, we'll have the money.
Well. Great.
No.
Great.
Well, yeah. Good, but it's not covered by revenue, so
yeah.
It's going to hit. It's going to make the tax effort not so good.
Correct.
Because the tax effort here is based on the revenue that we're putting.
Yeah.
All right.
Yes.
So.
Yeah.
We still plan.
Yeah.
So we have to be careful. You know, you can't double count. Sorry, I'm just being flipped. So.
It's late.
So, shall we? You want to look?
Where we wanted to be, right? So.
Yes, it is. You
want to
look
at
the
revenue? Well, that's what we wanted. More rather than one, because it was 1.97 all of them.
Yeah, it's actually we made an improvement. Now, did we
I
keep the $1,000 for the fire?
Yes, we did. Yes, we didn't make that change.
We didn't. We did not.
We did not.
We just take a peek at
sure.
that.
Yeah. Keep it away.
Yeah.
The salaries for the on-call people?
Yes.
We left it the same.
Oh, good. So can I unhighlight this?
Unhighlighted it
okay.
before.
Right.
I still say if you're willing to rent a burning building for $8 an hour,
mm-hmm.
you are
okay.
a saint.
Exactly. All right, so should we look at revenue to make sure we're in the rooms? It's not open. Yeah, it's not open. So this is the $10,000 that you know, we might use if from a in exchange tax fund if we need it.
Yeah.
Resident taxes,
mm-hmm.
timber taxes, interest on taxes. These are pretty much all the same. We did increase motor vehicle permits. It's a lot of cars, but we are going to do that this amount
this year
yeah. it looks like. This is the surcharge, so the change is because when we
sure.
we anticipated last year.
I didn't get that.
Yeah. What was your birthday?
May.
Yeah, it was late. It was late. So we didn't get as much revenue this year as we anticipated, but we should get it all next year because it's now fully in place.
Yeah.
We did decrease building permits because, you know, this got decreased. So this is other license permits and fees. That also got decreased.
Well, because you've got a thistle permit on there,
aren't
they?
Well, we didn't
and
decrease
not required.
It.
Not
required. Do you want it?
I mean, it doesn't have to go away because people still, I mean, there's a benefit to people applying for that. Like, especially
yeah.
if you want to go across state lines.
I would make it on
there. I don't know if go that low. I mean, how much are they? $40 each? So, you're 40. No, it's $10 a year. I think they're good for 4 years. But that's why they're.
I have no wisdom on this line. I'm waiting for the two of you to guide me on this.
I don't know. I
don't
have one. They're good for 4 years and $10 a year, I think. Like our light driver's license now costs about $50, but they're good for 5 years.
Oh,
I think 60 or something. Clerk at the pharmacy didn't give me mine back. It was a real ID. I got my allergy code.
next cycle anyway.
Get it done now.
Because
when all people are waiting.
In 2019 or 2020.
Yeah, you have to have more photo IDs.
It's a giant pain to get it, but.
It is.
But think about it, so all people that are putting off, because a lot of people went out at the game and were putting it off, like, good luck, whoever goes in 2020.
Now I couldn't imagine what it'd be like.
All right, so here it is.
So here's motor vehicle permits through quarter three, 168,000 revenue.
Motor vehicle permits?
Yeah, motor vehicle. So I'm looking for the pistol. So it is true, we only had 120 through quarter three.
We got 120 people.
$20.
Oh, okay. Yeah, Bob said they had a handful of people that wanted them. So if they're 120, they're $40 each.
No. That's the revenue through quarter three.
Yeah.
$120.
Yeah.
So you could estimate through quarter four.
I want to say I paid $10. There's nowhere on there that I say 10.
180. So you could project it. It's like $180 for the full year. So you downgraded to 200. This is for the DRA. I was expecting little bonuses and I didn't get them. That's a decrease. A $3 increase in the state highway. So. But here's the supplemental, right? So we could get a supplemental.
But
change in the railroad tax. So income to departments is up this much because of police detail.
Okay.
So we're still waiting for confirmation from Caroline that, so this is the revenue based on the $60,000 on the expense line.
Mm-hmm.
And Bob said, check with Caroline. So I've asked her, is this sufficient? I mean, can we legitimately expect more?
Mm-hmm.
Should we decrease this? So this is going to stay highlighted until we figure it out. This will stay highlighted until we figure out if there's any revenue to offset the library budget. This has been decreased because the rate increased in the
Did we, and
so it's the same.
We still have the $10 for the first and $5 for the second?
Yes.
Okay. What if we just made $10 across the board for all the separate?
That was the motion.
It was? I thought it was.
Thanks, Mike.
No, that was the motion. I didn't go for it because I was upset, and I want to talk about it now, and we'll talk about it on Monday.
Okay.
But
I'm sorry, Jordy, I guess maybe I misunderstood. I'm an idiot. I hope that's on tape, but I admit it.
We can talk about it, but it's already in place. We look like really freaking crap, or just stumble bumps and whatever. But we can talk about that. This is down to just cemetery lots, right? The sale of municipal properties. This included the Jesse Doe transaction.
Yeah.
Other, if you want to take a look at the other tab. So Hydro's still highlighted because I haven't heard from our new operators. So hopefully we can hear something soon. And hopefully it's not a decrease. Things here are pretty much just the same.
Mm-hmm.
Except here's the miscellaneous reimbursement to go with the expense, exact amount of the expense side. And we had have separate, used to have a separate line for bank fees, but it's part of that miscellaneous reimbursement, so I zeroed it out.
Yeah.
It's just cleaner, you know, easier to, to do the calculations. So that's other. Capital reserve funds, this is a wash because they're covered. So we'll get this from capital reserve funds in order to spend the money. So so we decrease this from our offsetting revenue, from our revenue, because none of this stuff can be used to decrease our tax effort in 2018. These are expected grants. These are one time. So we've decreased the what we're thinking we might use from fund balance to 50,000 because of these one-time grants. And of course, we won't have any proceeds of financing at the moment anyway. So that's where this revenue figure comes from, 166.56. So make sure the link, the links are not necessarily in place right this very moment. All right, so it's 166.56 minus this, which seems about right. All right, so that's where we are.
Yeah.
So I can support this. just so that, so it's an increase. So this was our tax effort this year. It's projected to be a 1.93% increase next year, or this.
Mm-hmm.
The municipal piece of the tax rate itself will go up 6 cents. 7 cents right now. So we still have a few things to sort through. That's where we are.
Okay.
All right. I think we're done for
2020.
What?
The money warrants now?
We know what the warrants are.
So those are the CIP then. That has a fiscal impact, right?
Right. What are you thinking? This isn't the full town warrant. This these would so this would let's take a look. So all right. So down here. Right. And, land appraisal. Right. So that those are warrants.
Mm-hmm.
Reserve funds, these are warrants.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we authorize the town to put this in there. We authorize the town to put 10,000 in the culvert, to put 10,000 in the conservation land trust fund.
Yep.
So those are our financially impacted warrants.
Okay.
Now other warrants, I mean, I haven't looked at that, but it's,
okay.
You know, whatever we do.
What about the emails that we've been getting about veterans? Other resolutions? Did we want to look at that?
I would encourage you, take a look at the RSAs,
obviously
take a look at the
look those numbers.
Right, so we can absolutely do that ourselves. You don't have to wait for a citizen's petition if we, the board, want to do that. So I would encourage you, if either of you has the time to do that, that would be a good one. I think that we are allowed to increase the income thresholds. I don't really know. You'd have to look at the RSAs.
Mm-hmm.
But there's having it itself. We've already done that. We know we have it. You know, we have an elderly.
Yeah.
The amount of the exemption is something I think we can control.
Mm-hmm.
Is it a 500? I don't, you know.
Yeah.
So, and then the thresholds.
Yes.
So I encourage you to take a look at that. I think Andrea would probably have a, their tax code, I don't know what they are.
In other towns?
No,
oh,
just
okay.
Here.
Oh,
no,
like
what it currently is here.
Oh, yeah.
Right?
Yeah, our sheet has that on it.
Our sheet has it, that's right. So that's what we currently have, and then we can, you know, it might be helpful to know when we last raised it, to, as we, if it's something we want to do, we don't have to do that right away.
Right.
Just, we can just decide what we want it to be, and then as we're justifying it going forward, then we can do the rest of that.
Okay.
Does that sound good?
Mm-hmm.
And if there's anything else, so this is, obviously, this is just a template,
mm-hmm.
right? So the highlight are the ones we need to change in the operating budget. So capital improvement reserve fund,
yep.
Conservation land trust fund, town revale. I think we're currently not planning to start this till next year. So this will probably go away. We never changed it. So these are just notes.
We legally changed it, and then they never changed it.
Oh, so maybe that
because
is why. So we have to put it. Okay, so we're going to have to do that.
They motioned to do it,
yeah.
And then it screwed everything else
yeah.
up, and then
okay, so that's why that's it. There. And this, we should get rid of the teachers.
I'm afraid the next board will forget to put it back in.
Put what back in?
The whole article.
This one?
Yeah.
So, what makes you say that?
I'm just afraid. Because we have to do it 75 years.
Mm-hmm.
So,
we could have started it this year. It is here. So, unless the board willfully ignores these 10 years' projections,
mm-hmm.
and there's nothing that requires a board to do that, there is 20,000 for 5 years long. Yeah, so then there's an off year again, and then
okay.
this may have to increase.
Okay,
so
good.
So it's there.
And
also, there's an inflator. So the operating budget right now is being inflated by 2%.
Okay.
The revenue is being inflated by 1%.
Okay.
And then this is the long-term loan comes off of the payment sheet.
Mm-hmm.
And right now it's an estimate for the USDA, but we don't know that one for sure. But it shouldn't be higher. This comes out of the, you know, the CIP. This is what the board talks about, and what I recommended we cut down to 10,000.
Mm-hmm.
So that's there. Now I did do this. I was playing around with the police. So the building is just one part of the expense. This is. You know, when I get around to it, I'll send something to the committee. Building is just one thing. You've got to figure out how does it affect the operating budget going forward?
Mm-hmm.
How does it affect the operating budget of this building going forward?
Right.
What is, you know, there's a lot of things that have
yeah.
to be figured out.
Sure.
But just for chuckles, I took 1.3 million
yep.
at 3%, which
yep.
might be still available at USDA for 30 years, and it's about 66,000 a year. So, if you start paying it back in 2019, but should something happen quickly, and you start paying it back in 2019, there's a 6% jump. But it sort of settles down because, see, here's the bond impact, assuming, you know, that it passes in 2018. It's not the full 60%, it's this. 25,000 because we're putting money,
right.
the CIP is putting money in anyway, not enough. So there is this one-time jump, and then of course once you've jumped, I hate to think that you're still doing another 2%, you know, it'd be nice to quiet it down for a year or so, and be disciplined and not do that. But we don't need to discuss that right now, I was just playing. Just what does it look like?
Right.
So that's the sticker shock that would happen. Now, if you know, we take a year to think this through and do all of the other projections and the costing out of all of these things, then that would go to 2020 and maybe it'll, you know, we'd be able to use the money that we've been, you know, so we can have that. But again, I'm just completely just playing around. Some of these loose ends straightened up. So one is the recreation.
Yep.
For committee and whether there's a team camp.
New arms for the highway, for the police. Bob's on detail right now, so he won't get back to you anytime today.
I thought there was another police question that came up there.
Don't you go to the farmer's market?